Good evening.
Good evening. Good evening.
I don't know whether you're excited or not, but I'm really, really excited to deliver my first icebreaker speech today out here with you all. Well, that's what I've been trained to say when I'm feeling nervous. I opened my eyes in a small place called Champa in Madhya Pradesh there, now in Chhattisgarh. I was born in a business class family, and there was this peculiar thing in it. So it was a huge joint family, and there was this peculiar thing in the family that every kid in the family would go to a boarding school. I don't know for what reason, but for sure they believe that. I don't know whether the kid will learn anything or not for sure, but the kid will start talking in English. So that was the belief the family had actually. So of course I could not make it to boarding school because I wasn't bright enough, and I was admitted to a small school from this Lions Club. So as a kid in the school, I had always been an MBBS, members of the backbencher society. So it was a kind of a school wherein any time during the day when the things are going out of the control and there's a lot of noise in the class and the teacher wanted to ensure a pin drop silence in the class, the teacher would just shout, "Ab har koi English mein baat karega." And then after that, nobody would talk because nobody would know how to talk. And there was just suddenly there's a pin drop silence in the class. So in the school as a kid, I was too submissive, and most of the times I was flabbergasted for things happening around. So school life was pretty boring for me. And soon school life was over and I landed up in college. Oh, by the way, engineers in the house, give me a cheer. So all the people who do not know me, for all the people who do not know, I'm a computer engineer from a place called Davangiri. And this place is in Karnataka, which is 250 kilometers away from Bangalore. And so the college life, for the first time in my life, I felt like Maverick of Top Gun. College life, for the first time, the college life is, you know, it's like in college life, you know, the falling in love, it was as easy as falling out of it. So the tragedy about my college life was that I was in South India, in the boys' hostel, having pathetic mess foods every day, surrounded by all frustrated boys. Can you see the chronology? So, okay, guys, make some noise if you've stayed in a boys' hostel. Okay, so I would like to tell you, ladies and gentlemen, you know, what does this boys' hostel do to you all? You know, after you've stayed in a boys' hostel, you see any girl. You see any girl and you fall in love with that girl. And it doesn't really matter who the girl is. She could be a student, teacher, professor, artist, mason. You have to fall in love with that girl. Because the feeling of scarcity was so strong that any girl you interact with and you start treating as if she's Disha Patani. So that was college life for me, and so I came to Delhi, and everywhere it was being asked, dare to think beyond IIMs. I said yes, and I did my master's MBA from Indian Institute of Planning and Management, and that was the worst decision I ever took in my life. I got a job in a training company. It's nearby in Connaught Place. It was a small training company. Initially, company invested a lot of money into me for me to become a great trainer. So initially, I was a kind of a trainer who once happened to reach late in a time management session. Can you imagine that? What a day that was. My boss really ensured I will cry blood for the rest of the month. He really took my pants off actually. And that was the corporate life for me. So after that, the best thing happened for me in my life. Can you guess what?
Joined Toastmasters.
I got married. Oh. It was 2012. No, it was, yeah, it was 2012. She would have killed me actually. Happily married. So I'm married, she's happy. You know, post my marriage, I happened to go to one of the party, and there was this gentleman, one of the acquaintances, who walked up to me and said, "Cool man, he's been married, you know, you have been married for quite some time now. So what is the strategy, man? What do you do? How do you do to be happy in married life?" I said, "Bada asaan hai." I said, "It's very simple." You know, when I make a mistake, I say sorry to her. When I don't make a mistake, then also I say sorry to her. So that's the strategy. So, whatever said and done, life has been absolutely amazing. So, on a weekend when I'm sipping my beer looking at the sky, I say one thing to myself, absolutely no regrets. So thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for your time and listening.